हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक टू हिस्ट्री क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट वीक वी लर्न अ न्यू लेसन एंड दैट इज आर विलेज एंड आर सिटी, करेक्ट? सो स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट डिड यू लर्न इन दैट लेसन? वी लर्न अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन विलेज एंड सिटी, करेक्ट? विच फैसिलिटीज आर अवेलेबल इन सिटीज, विच फैसिलिटीज आर नॉट अवेलेबल इन विलेजेस, करेक्ट? So in this way we observed two pictures and we compared village and city, correct? So students, we have seen that in village houses are small and in city there are tall buildings. One more is there, in village there are less vehicles, correct? And in city there are more vehicles. So why do we use that vehicles? So vehicles are used to go from one place to other or to send some goods from one place to other. So students, that process is called transport. Transport means what? To carry people from one place to other or to carry goods from one place to other, that is called transport. So students, today we are going to learn about transport. So let's start. So students, you can see here, transport means to carry people and goods from one place to other. Modes of transport. So students, transport is carried over by four ways: roadways, railways, airways and waterways. See again, roadways, railways, airways and waterways. These four are modes of transport. So students, now we will learn about transport and we will see these four modes of transport. So students, let's watch one video and in that we will see all these things. Okay students, are you ready? Okay, let's start. So students, transport means to carry people and to carry goods from one place to other place, that is called transport. So there are two types of transport: old means of transport and modern means of transport. So students, let's see first type, that is old means of transport. Here you can see bullock cart, correct? So bullock is used to carry people and goods. So in olden days, animals were used to carry burdens. Like bullock, one more animal is there, that is horse. You can see here horse cart. It is also used to carry people and goods from one place to other place. So students, many types of animals were used to carry people and burdens. Now see the next picture. Here some people are carrying one person and that is called palki. Means here human power is used for transport. Okay students, so that is called human powered transport. You can see in this picture also man is pulling cart. So here also human power is used for transport. So students, in old days, animals like bullocks, elephants, camel, horses and donkeys were used for transport. Okay students, as man's needs increased, he invented new means of transport. Okay, so next we will see new means of transport. Can you see picture here? Here picture of bullock cart, cycle, train and aeroplane. So there are different modes of transport used to go from one place to another, and these four modes are roadways, railways, waterways and airways. So see the first way, that is the roadway. Okay, so roadway is more in India. So here you can see many types of vehicle
run on roadway. Okay, so first is bus, that is the public means of transport. If you want to go from one place to other, you can use this public means of transport. So you can see various type of buses, auto rickshaw, trucks, tempos, etc. Okay students, so this is called roadways. Next way is the railway. See the picture. Can you see railway track here? Okay, so railway track is used for transport. Okay students, so we have to build that roadways and railways. Okay, so train is the faster means of transport than bus or roadways. Here you can see people are going by using the train. Okay, so railway is the faster means of transport. Then train is also used to carry goods from one state to another state, means for export and import of the goods train is used. So students, see the next picture. It's the picture of railway station of Kankauli. So if you want to go in other places, you can use train, and that is the railways. So railway is the faster means of transport. Now we will see fastest means of transport, and that is the airways. See the picture carefully. So students, you have to build railways and roadways, but there is no need to build ways for aeroplane. Okay, so aeroplane is the fastest means of transport, and it is very comfortable that many people can carry through aeroplane. Now one more way is there, that is waterways. Can you see here? So there is no need to build waterways. It's a natural way. So various type of small boats, then big boats, then very big ships are used to carry people and used to carry goods. So see the picture carefully. Okay students, so now we will see seating arrangement. So see the seating arrangement in the bus. So now we will see the seating arrangement in railway. So you can see here, it's a big seating arrangement and big fans are there, and there is a place to keep your luggage. So it is more comfortable than bus. Now see the next picture. This is the seating arrangement in aeroplane. So you can see that seating arrangement in aeroplane is more comfortable than bus and train. Okay students, so today we have learned four ways of transport: roadways, waterways, airways and railways. These are four types of modes of transport. Okay students, so nowadays transport facilities are available in both village and city, and it is very necessary. Okay students, so these are means of transport. Now students, see on your page number 41, pictures are given and you have to match them. So in column first, there are some pictures like bullock cart, boat, railway. Okay, so now we will match the pairs. Okay, so first is the bullock cart. So which way is used for bullock cart? So see in next column, you can see road. So roads are used to carry bullock cart. Now see the second picture. Second picture is of boat. So boat means which way? That is water way. Third picture is of train. So for train we used railway. Then for bus, there is again roadway. Aeroplane, airways, and again truck is the roadways.